Oh.
Never try this at home.
Hello, Worldwide friends! So in the previous video, we decided to make an awesome Stormtrooper helmet that has an air cleaner so it could block fine particles. In this episode, we're gonna make it in rear. So this is the 3D printed model, and it's red because we applied some putty on it.
It smells bad!
Since original 3D printed model has lots of gaps and dirty lines on the surface, we need to first sand it and smooth it before you paint it. So, let me tell you what happened a few days ago. Wait. Before that, we made a new chant. Remember, like, subscribe, Condor. You ready? Let's begin. It's working. Hey. Yo,
what,
man.
What,
hey.
What?
Can you do me a favor?
What's it?
Oh, so I need to sand and polish this stuff. Mm-hmm. And I know you are the best guy who can handle this, so could you?
No, you choose the wrong guy.
Hey, please.
Go away.
I'll buy you a fried chicken.
What? What chicken?
Yeah.
Okay, I take it.
I'll never buy him a chicken.
Now we'll smooth this massive stuff. First thing I'm gonna do is sanding. If you look at the back side of sandpaper, there is a number. Bigger the number, finer the sandpaper is. Start with small number such as 100 and continue with different digit of sandpapers, increasing the number. You may wonder why I don't use a grinder. Yes, I also have a grinder, but 3D printing material has a low melting point and such device rotates so fast that it would melt the surface. I know it's really annoying, but sometimes your hand is better. Okay, sanding is over, but it's just the beginning. If you look at the surface here, there are a lot of gaps. To fill these gaps, I'll use the super toothpaste. Just a joke. This is not a toothpaste, it's super red putty. A putty or body filler is used to fill the gaps on the surface. So you take this and squeeze it as much as you need. You may have to mix the thinner in this process, but the product we use already contains it, so you don't have to. There are so many types of putties out there, so read the manual carefully and choose the right one for you. Now grab a little stick like this and put the putties on the surface like this. Make sure you spread it really thin or it won't dry forever.
I finished.
Now you should buy me a chicken.
No, you did it only once. You should send at least 3 times. Oh,
what? You didn't say that. That's unfair.
You don't want a chicken?
I hate you.
No. Keep going. Good luck to you. While he is sanding the helmet, I'm gonna build an air cleaner. So, this is a HEPA filter I bought in the internet, and it costs about $5. And the point is, should this really block the fine particles well? When I searched in Wikipedia, I found some ranks of those filters. So, what I got is E12, and it says it won't block any fine particles. Wait, what? So I bought this one, and it's H13, which can block 99.95% of particles that are larger than 0.3 micrometers. Pretty good. So now I'm gonna put the filter and the cooler inside here. But as you see, these are too big to fit in there.
Come on, come on.
So I'll be cutting them first using bandsaw. Built a structure like this, the filter goes in here, and if you want to change it, you can just put it out like this. That easy. And keep in mind that you need to change the filter every 6 months. Okay, so now I'm gonna weld this helmet. And would it work? Wind blowing in here. Well, it's really cool. Oh,
hello, jerk.
Huh? Seems like it's working as expected. Mission complete! Yay! Checklist. Post processing.
Check.
Air cleaner.
Check.
So the work left to do is just all sealing, painting, HUD, and finally megaphone. So we're gonna work on these two in the next episode. Sorry, dude. So next episode, finishing this awesome helmet. See you next Cold Earth Thursday. Like, subscribe, Cold Earth.